Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Angular drop-down list from Syncfusion. Imagine you are about to answer a poll that asks your favorite sport. You would like to select a sport name from a list instead of manually typing it. The drop-down list lets you do this. You choose an item from a huge collection and then display that item in the UI. You can bind hierarchical data and do filtering, grouping, and UI customization with templates, as well as create a cascading drop-down list. Now, let me show you the steps to create an Angular project using the Angular CLI tool, and we'll edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and finally, I can view the output result on any of the supported browsers. First, I need to install the Angular CLI in my machine using this command, npm install -g at angular/cli. As I have already installed Angular CLI in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Next, I am going to create a new Angular project, so I use this command, ng new project name. I have named my project Angular DropDownList. This will create an Angular project and its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder. To use the Syncfusion Angular drop-down list, I need to install the Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package using this command, npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-dropdowns --save. This will install the Angular dropdowns package and its dependencies. Now, I am going to open this application in Visual Studio Code. The first thing I need to do is import the dropdown list module from the Syncfusion dropdowns package. Navigate to the app module file and import the dropdown list module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular dropdowns package and register it within the imports array of the ng module section. Now, let me make changes in the app component HTML file by replacing its default content with the Angular dropdown list code. Next, I need to populate the data for the dropdown list. So, let me open the app component TS file. Then, I will define the object variable localData and assign an array of objects that holds two fields, ID and game. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the dropdown list component. So here, I need to define the variable data fields, map this ID to the value field, and map game to the text field. I assign this localData to the data source property, and this data field's variable to the field's property. This data source contains a list of sports, so let me define placeholder property and set the value select a game, which will be displayed in the drop-down list component as a description. Along with this, I also need to define CSS for drop-down list, so let me import the material theme and style.css file. Now, I will save this application and run it using the command ng serve. When you look at the drop-down list, you can see the sports listed. You can also see that the drop-down list displays the short description, select a game. By default, the pop-up width will automatically adjust according to the drop-down list input element's width, and the default height is 300 pixels. To set a custom height and width for the pop-up, I need to define the pop-up width and height properties with custom values. Also, I have defined few CSS style for this class element, control section, within this style.css file. So now, look at the drop-down list component, where the pop-up is displayed with a custom height and width. If I want to bind a remote data source to the Angular drop-down list, then I may need to make use of the data manager. The data manager acts as a gateway between the drop-down list and data source, and also uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. So, as a first step, I need to import the data manager and required adapter from the EJ2 data repository. Then, I define an instance named remote data for the data manager with properties like URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I use the already available remote URL service, which retrieves the list of data through post action and then binds the data to the drop-down list. Also, I have set Web API adapter here, as the URL is assigned with the existing web API service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Next, I write the query to fetch the first 10 data points from the employees table. Then, I import query from the EJ2 data repository to access the query class. I also need to map this first name and employee ID to the text and value fields, respectively. Next, I will assign the instances remote data and data query to the data source and query properties of the drop-down list. I have set employee names as data sources, so let me change the placeholder property value to select a name. And now, you can see the drop-down list shows employee names over here. The drop-down list displays data items in the data source order. To reorder data items in ascending or descending order, I need to use the sort order property. Now, I am going to sort these items in descending order. So, let me define the property sort order and set its value to descending. So here, data items in the drop-down list are in descending order. In this video, we have seen how to create an Angular CLI project using Visual Studio Code and add a Syncfusion Angular drop-down list to it. Also, we have seen how to load JSON and remote data sources to the drop-down list. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description part below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.